I'll give it to you in 15 seconds. This isn't the whole presentation, but I'll give it to you in 15 seconds. If you type IPAWS, how to sign up into Google, into Bing, into DuckDuckGo, it'll take you to the right page. Anyway, there are four steps to signing up for IPAWS. They're basic steps. Simone mentioned one of them that we moved up to the first step. The first step is you complete the IPAWS web-based training. She said it would have helped her a lot, and it helps you figure out what you should be looking for from their from the perspective of learning software vendors. So that's why we encourage you to take the training up front. It's 2 hours of your life you're not going to get back through an EMI experience, which many of you have had. The difference is we did our best to avoid the little gotcha questions at the end of the training session. If you've taken EMI training, you probably know what those are. You know, when you swap the words around. Anyway, so it's IS-247B course is for alert originators, the button pushers, and the IS-251 course is for alerting administrators. There's an ever-increasing number of software vendors out there. If you go in as an informed customer, you're going to have more a better understanding of what's available. We have videos that are of demonstrations that have been done through the IPAWS TTSF. You can watch those. You can talk to your neighbors. Many of you have some sort of an alerting software package where you can add an IPAWS module to the existing package. IPAWS MOAs, the paperwork. Well, it's electronic paperwork. They have a lifespan of 3 years, and you have to renew. If that's the next step in the process for new folks, you apply for an IPAWS MOA. We ask you for your points of contact and what learning software we're going to use. We use that to fill out your draft IPAWS MOA, then send it out to you for local review and signature. Why 3 years? We didn't pull it out of the air. It's a cybersecurity requirement. So, if for the COGS that have been around for a while, if the alerting authorities have been around for a while, if you haven't updated your IPAWS public alerting authority, you probably ought to take a look at it. Blue alerts, DMO, and the ability to use RWT for live testing, like Rob Dale talked about earlier, earlier on. Telephone outage emergency was not available for WEA, and National Weather Service is now providing a good opportunity to send messages through IPAWS to National Weather Service, and they'll put it on NOAA weather radio for you, which is a great way to reach areas where there's a good percentage of weather radios, and you may not have the best of luck with communications through cell phone or broadcast. The public alerting authorities, the application's changed a bunch, and it will change again. We're going to automate this a little bit more, and it'll be a lot easier to fill out. But that's the difference between the old form and the new form. You get to check those things. And like I said, the National Weather Service stuff is over here in the third column. You ought to consider that as you go. Yes, this slide has been up before. Yes, how many of you that are out there have IPAWS MOAs that have expired? Please check them. We'd love to hear from you. We'd love to have it updated. We'd love to have the current points of contact, email addresses. Keeping that up to date helps us a whole bunch. Now, we're almost back on schedule. And I'll turn it back over to you, Justin.